All right, this is John Cola with OKRaw.com. We have another exciting episode for you, and one of the last episodes from the Canada Fruit Festival 2019, where I get to meet so many cool new people, some of my fans, and also see old friends. So I met Lissa, I think last year, actually at this event. I made an amazing video with her that I thought was just a wealth of knowledge, and you should watch it if you haven't already. The link is down below. But, you know, I want to get her in again to share with you guys some of her personal experience. She's been doing raw foods for 5 years now, had this amazing YouTube channel, Lissa's Raw Food Romance. I'll post a link down below if I remember, or I will do that. But yeah, amazing channel. I follow you and watch some of your videos sometimes. They are excellent. And you know, I'm glad you're able to motivate so many people to eat more fruits and vegetables, which is what I am all about as well. And you have your own story, your own journey. We're not gonna get into all that, but what I will tell you is that Lissa has lost 70 pounds on basically by eating fruits and vegetables. And it's super simple, super easy. In my opinion, eating fresh fruits and vegetables is the best way and most sustainable way to lose weight, not any of these fad keto diets or Weight Watchers diets or whatever diets it is, because you know, eating fruits and vegetables, in my opinion and in my life, is my lifestyle, not simply a diet. It's something I'm doing for my entire life, because besides, you know, normalizing my own personal weight, right, it's also given me extraordinary health and anti-aging and longevity and performance in my life and clarity of mind, you know, feeling good, you know, having better brain chemistry. So many things it can affect, but now we're going to focus specifically on weight loss and how to do it. So Lissa, you want to surely tell your story, maybe a condensed version, because I know we could be here all day for that, and on your weight loss and all that, all this kind of stuff, just to get some people up to speed that may not know you.
Perfect. Well, thank you, John, for having me on. This is so awesome to be on your channel again and to meet you again here. So great to connect with old friends. Yeah. Thank you. So I lost 70 pounds. It took me 14 months. I became a raw vegan.
And you kept them off.
Yeah, kept it off. I mean, I've fluctuated here and there. You know, tip number two, you'll want to see that, because that's something that I have noticed has affected my weight. But I have kept the 70 pounds off. Over the last 4 years, because it took a year to lose the weight. But I went raw, fully raw, in 2014, September. And I had been playing around with raw for about 10 years before I actually went raw, because I was scared of eating too many calories. I was so scared to go low fat, you know, all of these other things, because I was stuck in that diet mindset. And you can't apply traditional diet mindset stuff to a raw vegan lifestyle. You just can't, because it doesn't work. You have to almost like forget it all and relearn a totally new way of living. And yeah, so that's what we want to share with you today.
So what's the first way to, you know, lose weight on a raw foods diet? Because you got to do these specific things to get the benefits you want, and Lissa has done it.
Yeah, so for me, probably the number one thing that I found that helped me to lose weight, and a lot of people are going to be a little conflicted with this, but is to eat a lot of calories. And I don't mean overeat, like you don't want to eat silly amounts of calories, but you want to eat enough to sustain your energy, to get all your nutrition, and to, you know, ward off cravings. Because if you're not eating enough, you're going to crave stuff. If you're going days and days eating low calorie, you're going to snap back and you're going to eat all the stuff that you don't want to eat that it's going to make you gain weight again, right? You're just going to yo-yo back and forth. But if you eat enough, making sure you're getting, you know, I say start with 2,000 calories and work from there. Maybe you need more because you're more active. Maybe you need less because you're a short person and you work a sedentary job. But you can work around with how many calories. I personally ate 2,100 to 2,300 calories a day while I was losing weight. And now to maintain my weight, I'm eating around 2,400 to 2,700 calories a day. I eat a little bit more if I'm, you know, exercising a lot. But that's about average for me, and it's going to be different for everybody. But I want people to make sure that they eat food. Make sure you're eating the proper amounts of food and the proper kinds of food. So fruits, fresh fruits and vegetables, if you're doing raw, make sure you get all, basically pretty much all your calories from fruits and vegetables, a small amount of nuts and seeds, which leads us into
tip number two. I want to talk about, you know, eating fruits and vegetables, and you know, the whole deal about eating enough food is getting enough calories met, so you have satiation of the calories, but along the journey of eating the calories, guess what you guys are also getting with fruits and vegetables? You guys are getting massive amounts of nutrition, vitamins, minerals, phytochemicals, antioxidants, all these different compounds and foods that help your body work how it should. You know, one of the things I would eat to lose weight on raw foods is I would eat purple carrots. They've done documented studies with, you know, rodents, which I do not agree with, that show even rodents drinking purple carrot juice and still eating junk food lost weight and got healthier, just because these antioxidants are so critical, and that's what's in the raw foods, the fruits and vegetables, simply by eating them. And of course, there's, in my opinion, better raw foods than not to eat, like colorful foods will have more pigments, and these are the pigments that our body really needs to make our bodies work properly, shed the excess weight, based on my opinions and the research that I've seen. So yeah, make sure you eat the proper amount. And for those of you guys that are a tip, because, you know, if you eat, you know, standard American, you eat like one Big Mac or something, it's like a 1200 calories, or I don't even know how many they are, but they're a lot, right? Yeah. And that's like one small piece of thing is like so many calories, but when you're eating fruits and vegetables like fresh, it's a lot of food you're gonna be eating. You might be like freaked out, oh my God, really? I gotta eat this many fresh fruits and this many vegetables to get my calorie needs. And if you've never done this, you won't know how many calories you eat. So you wanna go to something like, you know, a Chronometer or fitday.com to track the calories you're eating, track the food you're eating at least for the first week or so. So you kinda get an idea, wow, I really need to eat this much food, because fruits and vegetables, they're mostly water weight. We don't want to be eating high, you know, low water weight foods, even if it's raw, like oils have zero water in it. They're high calorie. These are not the kind of raw foods we're talking about. We're talking about eating a fruit and vegetable dominated diet with some amounts, small amounts, maybe a handful of nuts and seeds, which are, you know, don't have the water content, but are concentrated nutrients nonetheless, all right? Yeah. So let's actually, Alyssa, move into tip number two.
Yes, tip number two would be to do low fat. And when I say low fat, a lot of people think no fat, which is not true. And I love thinking of it as an appropriate amount of fat. But if you say an appropriate amount of fat, most people have no idea what an appropriate amount is. But it is a low fat diet, which I believe is around 10%. It could be anywhere between 5 and 20%. That's kind of where I say people need to fluctuate between. Some people need a little bit more, some people need a little bit less, but I think, I mean, I read a study at some point where anything over 20% and the higher you go, the more gut dysbiosis can happen. So, you know, sticking around that lower fat range, nuts, seeds, I focus on seeds like chia, flax, that kind of thing, and maybe a smaller amount of avocados, young Thai coconut meat maybe, and just keeping it on the low end. So for me, while I was losing weight, I was doing high fruit or all fruit in the morning, and then I would do fruit for snacks here and there, and I would do a giant salad for lunch and a giant salad for dinner, and the dinner salad is where I had my fats, and I would put my fats with a little bit of like darker leafy greens in there to get the extra absorption. So that's what I did, and I was so scared to do a low fat diet, because, you know, the keto crowd was all saying, no, you need all this high fat and lots of protein. So I was really scared to try the low fat, but that is what finally eventually worked for me, and it was sustainable because I could eat a huge amount of calories, still get a decent amount of fats, and lose weight at the same time. Now, throughout my journey, I have fluctuated here and there with, you know, like 10 pounds, like not too much, but I have noticed that those times I'm eating higher fat percentage. So I'm eating more nuts, more avocados, you know, on top of my salads that I typically eat. So those times I do notice that I do gain a little bit of weight, but then when I rein it back down to the 10% range, I personally like 8% is my favorite.
It's a bit low in my opinion.
Yeah,
whatever works for each person.
I like 8%. Sometimes I go up to 12, 15%. It really depends on the day.
So how many nuts or seeds does that mean? Like a handful or half of a handful? Or just give somebody a concept or an idea.
Probably about a quarter cup of nuts.
Quarter cup, all right.
Yeah, or half an avocado tends to be enough with maybe some chia seeds in the dressing. And that's about how much. But like the more calories you eat, like if you're eating like 2,000 calories worth of just fruits and vegetables, you can eat more fats and still remain in that 10%
range,
right? So it really is a percentage. If you're only eating 1,200 calories,
then you don't eat that much fat either.
You're not eating a lot of fat at all. It's like 13 grams a day, which is way too low in my opinion. But if you're eating 2,700 calories or 3,000 calories, 10% is like 35 grams. So you're getting a fair amount while you're still eating a lot of food. And it's hard for people sometimes to wrap their minds around the fact that they're eating a lot of food and that's gonna make them lose weight. and they don't realize that it is the combination of the nutrition, the energy that they're getting, their metabolism is working really well because you're constantly feeding it, and the lower fat, because the fat can interfere with insulin, I find. The higher fat that I eat, the more sluggish I get, the more cravings I get, and that kind of thing. But again, yeah, you want to play around with your percentage and find where you feel the best, but a low fat in general is what I believe for
all right, great. Yeah, there's a nice range that you could have in there and find out what works for you. And I think the other reason why fruit and vegetables work is because, number one, you got to eat a large volume because they're high water content, mm-hmm. so you're staying hydrated very poorly. And another thing you didn't mention, sorry,
yeah,
is
okay.
the fiber. Oh my God, fiber is so important.
Yes.
Fruits and vegetables are so rich in fiber. And yeah, oh, John, we don't need fiber. There's no requirement for fiber. So yes, there's no requirement for fiber, but to keep your microbiome happy, right?
Yeah.
Microbiome is your beneficial microbes, bacteria, fungi, yeast in your gut that help you digest food and even make metabolites after they eat the fiber. They basically poop out antioxidants, they poop out nutrients, they poop out so many different things that are actually good for us and help our bodies make it all work. And part of the reason why, you know, a plant-based fruit and vegetable diet works is because you're feeding the fiber to your microbiome. You're gonna have a happy microbiome, and if you're eating meat and animal products and, you know, things like that, you know, you're gonna, in my opinion, get the wrong kind of microbiome, because we want healthy microbiome based around fruits and vegetables that have even beneficial microbes on them, and also the fiber feeds our microbiome, whereas, you know, animal foods don't have any fiber, they don't feed your microbiome.
Yeah,
you know,
agreed.
So that's 100%. Super important, because you know, I mean, one of the things they've done fecal transplants with people that are thin to people that are, you know, overweight, and, you know, the person was more likely to actually become thin because now they had a healthy microbiome. Now, mm-hmm. you may not want to do fecal transplants, it sounds kind of gross, but you do want to start eating fruits and vegetables so that you could get your own proper microbiome by simply living and eating properly, because you've been eating the wrong foods all these years.
Yeah, so they have the wrong colony going
right.
on in there. You want the right colony that comes from the fresh fiber.
All right, Lisa, so tip number three.
Tip number three would be to switch your focus from the weight loss to overall health. Mm-hmm. And that's what I did when I went on this whole raw vegan journey. I did not do it for weight loss. Sure, I was like 190 pounds and I wanted to lose weight, but I was not focused on that at all. I was focused on, because I had heart palpitations every night, I had a crazy face full of acne, my joints were incredibly painful, my female cycle was totally off and super painful. Like, everything in my life physically was out of balance, and I was doing this for health. And when I went on it for health and focused on health, the weight just naturally just came off, because I was treating my body with the utmost respect, giving it the best quality food that I could find in my area. I need to find even better stuff. But just focusing on the health made it so much easier, because people are looking at, you know, if they need to lose like 50 pounds or whatever, it could take them a year. And for some people, that's too far away. And focusing on just the health makes it so much easier.
Right. Yeah. I mean, I got into actually changing dietary changes, juicing fresh fruits and vegetables, eating this style of diet because of my health. And as a consequence, you know, one of the things was I lost weight. I didn't lose like 70 pounds.
Yeah.
Maybe I had like 15, 20 pounds to lose, which I totally have gotten rid of and kept off. So actually I'm the same weight I was like in high school.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and if you look at healthy, long-term people that are eating this style of diet, whether it's 5 years like Lisa here, whether, you know, I've been doing it nearly 25 years now at this point, well, next year will be 25 years. Some of their friends and speakers here, you know, 15, 20 years, we're all in like, you know, fit shape.
Mm-hmm.
And some of us work out more. I don't tend to, I could probably do more exercise.
Me too.
You know, I could,
me too.
I'll admit to that on camera.
Same
and,
here.
You know, maybe you guys could account me to that. And John, let's go for a run, man. Like, take me running, man. I don't like running. I like sprinting. I don't like super running and all this stuff. But I get enough physical exercise, because here's the thing. I'm not burdening my body with extra calories that I have to burn off, because I eat according to my personal needs, which is my hunger level. You know, when I'm hungry, I eat. When I'm not hungry anymore, I stop eating, right? I don't eat because it's 8, I don't eat it because it's noon, I don't eat it because it's 5, it's dinner time. I eat when my body's hungry and it's calling me to eat, then I eat. And when I feel full and satiated, I stop eating. I mean, that could be another kind of hidden tip within this video.
Yes.
So listen, so that was that tip. So what's tip number what? We're up to 4, right?
So yeah, tip number 4 would be focusing one day at a time. Now, like I had mentioned in the previous tip, some people are like thinking far out there. It's going to take me forever to lose all of this weight. When you just, you know, make it small and focus on daily goals instead of, you know, yearly goals. Yeah, you're going to get there eventually. But if you just focus on one day at a time, I would actually wake up every single morning and I would tell myself, today I am a raw vegan. I don't need to worry about being raw for a week or doing a 30-day challenge or being raw for a year or starting on New Year's and all of this stuff. I didn't focus on any of that. I just woke up in the morning and I said, today I am a raw vegan. So if I'm a raw vegan today, what am I going to eat for breakfast, lunch, and dinner? And that's all I thought about. Sure, I bought, you know, extra lettuce for the next days and stuff like that, but I was solely focused on one day at a time. Because if you're focused on one day at a time, you know, you do your day and then you wake up the next day and you're like, today I am a raw vegan. And then you do the same thing. And then the next day, today I'm a raw vegan. It's so much easier to focus one day at a time than to be so overwhelmed with the future.
Wow. So, I totally agree. You know, one day at a time. And even if that means like I got to go shopping every day and buy food every day and bring it in. But, you know, I would recommend shopping a few times a week and having all your food. And that's the other thing, right? Have all the food you need, you know, in your home. You know, have a nice display on your dining room table of like a big bowl of fruit, so it's always right there to grab. You know, get rid of the junk food, the processed foods, the animal foods, the processed vegan foods in your cupboard, your cabinets, so that's not even a temptation, and only make fruits and vegetables available. Like if you come to my house, I mean, you ain't eating nothing unless you're eating fruits and vegetables, maybe some nuts and seeds and some freeze-dried fruits and vegetables and things. I mean, if my brother, you know, my nephew comes over, guess what I'm feeding them? I'm feeding them fresh juices and fresh smoothies because that's what they want, or they're eating fresh fruits. Normally, they like smoothies usually, so I make my family smoothies because they're not necessarily on my diet. My brother does weigh, you know, for being younger than me, he weighs 190 pounds for eating standard American diet, has some health challenges. Meanwhile, you know, I'm 145 pounds and in good shape, yeah. You know.
Yeah, it really is the diet. And yeah, I agree with you. Like shopping, I go about every 2 days, maybe every 3 days. It depends, but you always focus just on that one day,
right.
On
Very
your meals.
Important.
Yeah, because some people are like, oh, well, what am I going to have, you know, next week or whatever? And it's too much.
Too much to deal with. They're like, I'm going to lose 70 pounds in a year. No, just focus on today and get it done and you'll be successful. And then you could build on your success. Like, wow, at the end of the night when you go to bed, you could pat yourself on the back. Today I was a raw vegan. I'm so happy.
Yeah.
My intention is to do it tomorrow. Wake up tomorrow. Tell yourself, I'm going to be a raw vegan tomorrow. Eat more fruits and vegetables. And, you know, pat yourself on the back, and it's a lot easier to accomplish. And if you can't do the full day, I'm just going to go till noon and be raw vegan. Mm-hmm. Once it's noon, hit it. Yep, great. I was raw vegan. And then, hey, from noon to nine, when I go to bed, I'm going to be raw vegan. You know, so if you got to break it down to the next 5 minutes, I don't care. Make a new goal every 5 minutes and be raw vegan. Eat more fruits and vegetables, the most nutritious foods on the planet, the ones that are going to allow you to lose weight. And more importantly, keep it off without all this yo-yo diet and stuff. With nothing extra to buy, you're gonna buy fruits and vegetables. You gotta buy a shop for food and buy something anyways. Why not buy fruits and vegetables? The stuff, best stuff on the planet that can sustain you and provide you the best health and, you know, the weight loss you're desiring. All right. So listen, we're down to the last and final tip today. Tip number five
wouldn't be diet related because I believe that we are a holistic being. We need to focus on other things other than just diet, because we can get obsessed with it a little bit. Some people can, but we have to focus on proper sleep and proper stress management, because those are two things that people kind of tend to forget about. They'll go to bed too late. Maybe they don't deal with stress properly. And then when they're really, really stressed out or they're really, really tired, they tend to fall back onto those foods that we shouldn't be eating. So if you can practice proper sleep and proper stress management, then you can really, it works really good, like kind of like willpower. You know, you don't need willpower if you're sleeping properly, if you're eating enough, if you're eating low fat. Like all of those things basically make willpower not really necessary, because you're covering all your bases and you're not letting your body request these things from yourself. So yeah, I would definitely say work on proper sleep management or sleep and stress management, so that you don't end up binging on other things.
Wow. And I will once again totally agree, whether you want to lose weight or you just want to be healthy, getting the proper sleep is of utmost importance. Because why? When we're sleeping, our body is healing and repairing, getting rid of things, you know, excess things that are not good for us, you know, putting it into our urine and our bowels so we get excreted when we wake up in the morning. Super important. And how do you know how much sleep is good? Well, I go to bed at midnight and I wake up at 4 because I got my job at 5 a.m. If you're getting 4 hours sleep, for most people in the world, 4 hours sleep is just not good enough, right? My general rule is, hey, John, go to bed when you're tired and wake up whenever you wake up. Whenever your body's ready to wake up, right, then I wake up. And then guess what? I know I've gotten enough sleep because I went to bed when I'm tired. I wake up when my body wakes me up, mm-hmm. whenever that happens to be. Now I have a job and created my life so that I could do this. Maybe you guys haven't. So if you are having to wake up early and you have to set the alarm, you hit the alarm a couple times and you still want to sleep in more, that's all right. That's just an indicator that, hey, I went to bed too late. I'm going to go to bed an hour earlier. And you're going to try to actually wake up before your alarm and also feel well rested when you wake up. If you wake up and you feel, I just didn't get enough sleep, I want to go back to bed, you didn't sleep long enough. So make sure you sleep long enough. And talk about stress. Oh my God, stress is so important. You know, it's so important to minimize and reduce. I like to say I live a peaceful life and staying a stressless or stress-free life, because the operand word there is stress. When you concentrate on stress, you get stress. You concentrate on what you tell yourself, right? And so I think the thing with that is, especially with sleep and stress, right, that raises cortisol levels. What does cortisol levels do? That increases your fat storage. So you definitely don't want to stress. If you got a girlfriend, a boyfriend, a husband, or wife that's stressing you out, maybe you got to shed that weight too. Maybe you got to get rid of that job you don't like that's stressing you out. I mean, it's not worth your health. It's not worth being fat because of a job that's paying you money that you know, it's just, it's a material thing. When you're losing your health, you're losing who you want to be because of a job, because of a person, because of whatever it is. So I want you guys to, and also, you know, coming down and coming into your mental mind game and just like letting things, somebody cuts you off, don't get all mad like, oh, they cut me off. They're, you know, they probably have a pregnant wife that's going to have a baby and she needs a C-section and she's going to lose her life or something unless she cuts you off and they kind of get there first. I mean, for by 2 seconds. I mean, who cares? Like, if you're stressed out and you're like always angry, guess what? You're going to be more likely to hold on to weight as that cushion that will comfort you, right? So we want none of this. We want to live a peaceful life and maybe even out a little bit and do some meditation or something. All right, so tips, Lissa.
Thank you.
But I know you have one more bonus tip for people. So what is it?
One more bonus tip would be to find your fallback five. These would be your top five favorite raw vegan recipes that are low fat and that you know how to make. They're really easy, like you've done them so many times. You always have the ingredients on hand and you know you're gonna love them. So if you're tired, you're stressed out, you're lonely, you're depressed, you're bored, you can make any of these five recipes and know that you're gonna love them. Because most people are like, if they get off work and they're tired and they're just like, I just wanna throw a pizza in the oven, you know, they don't wanna do any of that kind of stuff. If they have these five recipes that they love, that they know how to make, they have the ingredients on hand, you can whip it up in 10 minutes. I can make a salad in 10 minutes, right? Because I've done it so many times that I can. And it takes time to figure out what your fallback five are gonna be, but you can try some recipes, you know, get some ideas online. I've got recipe books. I mean, so many people have recipe books, but yeah, definitely finding your fallback five really helps in those times for cravings.
Cool. So what were your fallback five recipes? Because I know you had it, right?
Yes, I do. And it changes every once in a while. I'll find a new recipe and I'll be like, that's number, you know, now it's number one. But right now, my fallback fives are my French dressing, my mango curry, my mushroom marinara, my ramen, and probably my taco salad. Those would be my fallback five,
Definitely sounds good to me. And do you have recipes on your recipe book for those exact recipes, or do you have YouTube videos on those, sharing those?
Yes, I have recipe books. I've got four right now. I'm working on my fifth. And you can find those on my website, rawfoodromance.com. And I also sell print versions on Amazon that you can find. And I do have YouTube videos with recipes, and I share some on my Instagram. Every once in a while, you'll find a recipe for, So I try to make... It's so delicious and easy for people to stick to this lifestyle. And if you can get a dressing that's really good, you can eat a lot of greens. And it's so easy to get a lot in. And you don't have to worry about it.
I totally agree. So along those lines is I like to, you know, I actually like to pre-prepare my food sometimes. So like I do juicing in bulk. I'll juice like a gallon or two in one sitting. It'll take me 1 or 2 hours. And I'll basically vacuum save it in mason jars in the fridge. I sometimes do this also with my dinners, my raw food soups and salads. I know I make extra stuff that I can't eat that night. And you know, in an awesome world, I'd actually make a recipe every night and eat that all and then be done with it. But you know, storing it under a vacuum, I feel it preserves enough nutrition and there's still way more benefit of eating something that I made fresh out of my garden, vacuum packed, and I'm eating it the next day versus like basically most anything else most people are eating, but that's not a justification. But then it also makes it easy. Some nights, you know, I'll like do a big recipe prep day and I'll prep you know, recipe or you know, salad or soup for the next 3 days when I make it one day, or I have juices usually for the next couple days. So then I just, when I'm running out the door, when I'm busy, I'm stressed out, I just don't feel like making stuff. I got stuff ready in the fridge. I'm just grabbing this and eating. If I feel like making something, then I'm gonna make it from scratch and eat it. If not, I'm gonna grab something already pre-made. That makes my life a whole bunch easier. Now, in the olden days, I used to make everything at the time and eat it more optimal, but you know, we have limited time to do things, and sometimes I just don't feel like making food. Instead of just not eating a good salad and eating some fruits, it's a lot easier.
Yeah.
I prefer to eat a salad and have it pre-made. You know, some of my raw food soups are amazing. I have videos on this channel how to make some of my raw food pepper-based soups that I love so much. I have videos on how to create your own dressings. They're gonna taste good. You know, there's just like a formula you need to go through. And then once you experiment and find the one you like, just stick with it. You know, I like to make different recipes and dressings all the time, and everything's always a little bit different, although I have a same base formula that I use. I'll post a link down below to a video on how to make a raw food soup with ingredients in your fridge, and how to make a salad dressing. You know, I have these videos that kind of like help educate people, not just say, do this recipe, but kind of empower you to come up with your own recipes.
Yeah, getting creative is so important too. Like playing with your food and getting in contact and finding that connection again with our food that we've lost. Because we just eat stuff that's been already prepared, or it's fast food, and we've gotten so used to that that we've lost that connection.
Wow.
So yeah, getting creative with your food and finding that connection, so vitally important.
Super important. Yeah, so I mean, I just want to encourage you guys right now, after you stuck through this whole video for like, I don't know, 20 some odd minutes, you know, you guys must be committed. And so I want you guys to take that first step. You know, I know if you haven't eaten fruits and vegetables before, it might be kind of weird, but that's all right. You know, I've helped so many people, and you know, sold juicers to people, that so many people that have lost weight, and more importantly, kept it off because they're not on some kind of crazy binge diet. But I want you guys to be consistent about this. You know, don't just lose weight on this diet and then, oh, I lost the weight, I'm gonna go back to something else. Yeah. Well, if you go back to what you're doing, you're probably gonna gain the weight back. Then you're gonna have to yo-yo, and we don't want you guys to yo-yo. We want you guys to make changes for life that are gonna stick, that are sustainable over the long term, so you could be of the healthy weight, like on my high school weight, literally, you know, for the same last 25 years I've been doing this. So, and you guys, you could look at my videos 10 years ago. I mean, oh, pretty much look the same. People are like, John, do you age? Well, yeah, this is also an anti-aging diet, most powerful anti-aging diet in the world, in my opinion, full of phytonutrients and phytochemicals and antioxidants. So listen, if somebody wants to learn more about you, you follow your videos, buy your recipe books, how can they learn more about you, follow you, and all this kind of stuff?
Thank you. I am on Instagram, most active, at Raw Food Romance. Facebook and YouTube is Lissa's Raw Food Romance. I am on Snapchat here and there, Lissa Raw Vegan, and you can find all of my recipe books on my website, rawfoodromance.com.
Cool, I'll put as many of those links as I can remember down below. Definitely interested in your Facebook, your YouTube, and your website, so you guys can learn more about Lissa and get from her. I mean, I know certain people kind of jive with my kind of stuff and my format, and you guys might watch this video and love Lissa, and you know, follow her, because I mean, we're all a bit different. We teach like pretty much the majority of the same stuff, but we all have a different take, and I mean, my voice is a little bit more hard, I'm loud, and she's a little more soft and nice, and but maybe not nice. Well, I don't know about that, but I think you're pretty nice. Sorry. So anyways, if you guys enjoy this video with Lissa, want me to do more videos with Lissa in the future, hey, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also, be sure to share this video with support groups that are people trying to lose weight, so they can learn about the healthiest diet and some of the tips on how you guys can lose the weight, and more importantly, keep it off and be healthy at the same time, and not be on some kind of yo-yo diet for the rest of your life. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on my new and upcoming episodes. I'll be coming out every 5 to 7 days. You never know where I'll show up, what you'll be learning on my YouTube channel. Make sure you click the little bell so you get notified as my new videos come out. And finally, be sure to check my past episodes. Past episodes are a wealth of knowledge, including the episode with Lissa last year about, you know, turning your diet around and eating better by just using some techniques. Once again, the link is down below in the description for that video. But I have so many other videos that can help you guys eat more fresh fruits and vegetables the healthiest way possible, and even in the save the most money possible by some of my shopping techniques that I love so much. So yeah, past videos, such a valuable wealth of information. Check them out. So I guess with that, my name is John Kohler with OKRaw.com. We'll see you next time. Until then, remember, keep eating your fresh fruits and vegetables. They're always the best.